Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 and not type 1. Our channel is primarily for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, what are the best herbs for pre-diabetes? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals, such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks. There are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. Now, I have stated before, and will reiterate, that I am not one who thinks the only way to treat disease is through modern medicine. There are traditional remedies that have worked for centuries with certain people and with certain conditions, and I will never scoff at anyone who feels they can use them to help themselves. I do stop when I hear the word cure when it comes to diabetes and pre-diabetes because I don't feel there is a cure for these illnesses, but am open to the word reversing. Now, that being said, let's take a look at a recent research item I have been working on concerning herbal remedies that may help with pre-diabetes. Now, before we start, I want to give you my working definition of an herb. An herb is any plant with leaves, root, seeds, or flowers used for flavoring food, medicine, or perfume. Some people have different ideas of what herbs are. So right up front, I want you to know what I consider an herb and its place in this video. Now, this will not be a comprehensive list, but a list of some of the herbs that I've come across in my research. Cloves. Cloves offer anti-inflammatory, analgesic, and digestive health benefits for those with diabetes. Cloves protect the heart, liver, and lens of the eyes of those rats that were induced with diabetes, according to studies. Now, this spice contains 30% of the antioxidant phenol in dry weight, along with antioxidants, anthocyanins, and quercetin. As a result, cloves have antiseptic as well as germicidal properties. It is also offers some anti-inflammatory, analgesic, and digestive health benefits for those with diabetes. Another study done with 36 participants with type 2 divided into four groups, wherein they were given 0, 1, 2, or 3 grams of cloves per day for 30 days, followed by a 10-day washout period for the following results. Serum glucose decreased from 225 to plus or minus 67 to 150 plus or minus 46. Triglycerides decreased from 235 plus or minus 63 to 203 plus or minus 86. Serum total cholesterol decreased from 273 plus or minus 78 to 239 plus or minus 47. And LDL decreased from 175 plus or minus 73 to 145 plus or minus 44. So a marked result, especially in serum glucose, dropping about 75 points. Rosemary. Now, rosemary helps normalize blood sugar levels naturally, an aromatic herb that is used commonly to add flavor and aroma to meats and soups. Rosemary also helps normalize blood sugar levels naturally in some patients. It promotes weight loss as well, which is a double boom for many of those with diabetes who struggle with weight. A research conducted in Jordan to study the effects of rosemary on lipid profiles in rats with diabetes proved that rosemary has no significant influence on serum glucose level and lipid profile of normal rats. But when rosemary extract was administered to those rats with diabetes for 4 weeks, their blood sugar levels reduced by 20% and cholesterol levels by 22%, triglyceride levels by 24%, and LDL by 27%, while HDL increased by 18%. Now, the study was published in the African Journal of Plant Science, Volume 6, in 2012. Great article. Oregano. Oregano is considered one of the best herbs to lower blood sugar levels. Popular in Italian, Spanish, and Mediterranean cooking, oregano is considered one of those best herbs. A Mexican study on the inhibition of advanced glycation in product formation by oregano majorum, L. in vitro, and streptozocin-induced diabetic rats. Long name, I know, but basically it's saying that there was oregano given to diabetic rats. And it revealed that oregano alleviated oxidative stress under diabetic conditions through the inhibition of lipid peroxidation. Oregano may also prevent and or delay the onset of renal damage. So don't skip on the oregano when you're cooking your next meal. Sage. Now, sage is considered another one of those herbs that can lower blood sugar levels. It can have a metformin-like effect, according to the study published in the British Journal of Nutrition. So you may want to consider cooking with this herb often. It has been used in traditional medicines for centuries as one of the important herbs to reduce blood sugar. Now, word of warning, taking high doses of sage along with diabetes medications might cause your blood sugar actually to go too low, a condition called hypoglycemia, so monitor your sugar closely. Turmeric is another one of those herbs that has antibacterial, anti-inflammatory, and antioxidant properties. A popular spice in Indian cooking and the main ingredient in has taken the world by storm. Turmeric has antibacterial, anti-inflammatory, and antioxidant properties, as we said, that all come together to help those with diabetes manage more stable blood sugar levels. It helps boost immunity and prevent infections that many diabetes sufferers are often vulnerable to. Studies conducted on rats prove that curcumin, the active ingredient in turmeric, is effective in reducing plasma glucose level and A1C, as well as improving the lipid profile. Many of those with diabetes also suffer from arthritis, since the sugar-laden blood and inflammatory process typical to diabetes damaged joints. Turmeric, with its anti-inflammatory abilities, also helps with these joint pains. Another great herb that I actually have done a video on, and you may want to check that one out, is called fenugreek. Now, fenugreek seeds help lower blood sugar. Multiple studies show that these seeds help lower blood sugar by slowing down the process of digestion and absorption of carbs in the small intestine. This action is similar to the prescription drug Acarbose. Now, you can soak the seeds overnight, use them in a recipe. You can directly chew on those soaked seeds or use fenugreek seed powder to attain desired results. And another herb that I know here in where I am from, in the South, is ginseng. And man, people in our area use ginseng for everything. And a 2012 review of ginseng in both animals and human beings found that not only does ginseng reduce insulin resistance, it lowers A1C levels. It's been used in traditional Chinese medicines for centuries as one of the most potent herbs for blood sugar control. Indian ginseng offers fantastic all-around benefits. Scientists are also researching the connection between diabetes and Alzheimer's, and Panax ginseng is a type of ginseng that is able to help with both. Well, there you have my herbs. Find ways to incorporate them into your diet daily and see if they help. Don't forget to check out my new ebook, and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.